welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new to my channel, my name is Anaya. Here on this channel, we talk about formulating. We make hair care and skin care formulations. I show you behind the scenes of being a business owner and also talking about legal steps to have a legal business and more. Today's video is a... I did a poll on YouTube about a month ago, I believe, or almost a month ago, and I asked, would you guys like for me to show you guys how to formulate a deep conditioning hair mask and or edge gel? 62% of you guys asked for edge gel and 38% of you asked for a deep conditioning hair mask. So we'll still get into the deep conditioners. Don't worry about the shampoos, all that. We're gonna get to that. Right now we are gonna work on making edge gel. So I actually have two parts. One is actually, which is researching and development. And then the second part will be actually me showing you how to formulate the edge gel. Before we get into this, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you aren't supporting or following my other businesses, which is Natural Nay and Natural Nay Formulations. Natural Nay sells hair care, skin care products that you will really love. It's formulated with organic ingredients by me. And then also we have Natural Nay Formulations, which actually is launching June 25th. But right now I am available to have courses or like one-on-one consultations with people, showing them how to make their own formula if they already have a formula made and or if they're getting into the formulating world. So if you would like that, I'll make sure to put the link down below for you to schedule a meeting with me. Also, Natural Nay Formulations also have a book coming out, and also I decided not to do private label but to just really teach people. I don't think I would have time to do private label and run Natural Nay Formulations and do YouTube, so I decided to just set it up to where it's more convenient to make sure I run everything and besides school, of course. But let's get into it. Before making a formula and formulating, we have to do research on the market. So you might ask, why research the market? You want to see who's already making similar products, what are some ingredients they are using, and are there any ingredients trending? Now we go to our computer and do some marketing research. I searched up edge gel ingredients. I see a list of chemical composition slash ingredients that list stearic acid, sunflower seed, glycerides, sorbitol, and more. So after I did that, I then scrolled down to people also ask and see a business ingredients to their edge gels. Then I opened another tab and Googled edge gels. Make sure you read and look at everything. So when I say that, look at the blogs if they have blogs. Look into certain things that's trending right now. What are people liking? What ingredients are really popular at this time? You want to look into everything, read everything. That's what makes you a better formulator. And not only that, that makes you understand the market better. So then when you're marketing your product or a product, you'll know how to reach your audience. Have a research notebook to have something to look at for later. And also not just to look at for later, but also to write down ingredients that you are interested in putting into your formula. You want to make sure you write those names down because we don't want to forget. Writing everything down makes us a better formulator. I've seen tons of business edge gels, clicked on some edge gels and compared the ingredients they use. Looking at the ingredients, I've seen main ingredients that are used such as water, Cetirith 25, PEG 7 glycerol, cocoa, PEG 7 hydronated castor oil, PEG 40 hydronated castor oil. Main ingredients are when you put your competitors' ingredients together and notice they have the same ingredients used in their product. Example, all the competitors that I looked at had PEG 40 hydronated in their ingredients list. So I noticed that I needed to look further into that ingredient and see if I actually wanted to be a part of my formula. Now we have done the research on what our competitors have in their ingredients list. Now it's time to figure out what ingredients we would like to formulate and make our edge gel. And we have to do research on those ingredients. Example, we are searching up PEG 40 hydrogenated castor oil. PEG 40 hydrogenated castor oil is also known for PEG 40 castor oil ethylate, which is multifunctional oil in water, emulsifier, surfactant, and foam booster. So when you're looking at the ingredients that you would like to use in your formula, we also have to see, is it oil soluble, water soluble? Does it have to be heated up? Does it go in the water phase, the oil phase? If you do not know what I'm talking about, please stop this video and click that I up above, and it will probably also be in the description box of my playlist of series on how to formulate, so you can understand everything that I'm talking about in this video. I will not be breaking it down, so I'm going to need you to stop this video so you can catch up and see what I'm talking about. So when we're looking into the ingredients, we also are looking for what temperature could the ingredient be at when we're warming up the ingredients. Is this temperature heat sensitive? We have to look into all of that. That's what makes us a better formulator, is when we're looking in our ingredients, understanding our ingredients, and formulating with them correctly. Also, the usage rate. We want to know the usage rate. Some ingredients, like the preservatives, can only be a 3% or whatever preservative. We have to look into that. You have to look into everything. What preservatives are you going to use? What preservatives that you're going to steer away from? What oils do you want to put in? Does it really work good? Does it, you know, like everything. You have to look into everything. So after researching all the ingredients that I would like to formulate, I am going to start figuring out, what do I want with this edge gel? I want hold. I want my edges to hold easily. I want it to literally glide on my hair. I can comb it out and it actually holds. I also want my edges not only to hold but to be moisturized while it's being styled, because you guys, I know I'm not the only one that loves my edges slayed and looking nice, but I also want my edges to be moisturized. I don't want to put an oil on after putting them on. I want it to be a moisturized edge gel. So not only do I want hold, I want a nice moisturizer on my head, on my edges, so they don't get brittle. And I also want the edge gel to have shine. I want my edges to be shiny. I want when I turn, it's shiny. I want shine. So what we have is hold, moisture, and shine. So when we're formulating this or making the formula, I need emollients and I need an ingredient that has a gelling agent but also that has a hold. So I'll need some other ingredients to hold with that. And I also want shine. I need to find an oil and or extract or something to add shine. Now we have come to the end of this video. Please make sure you like, comment below, and subscribe. Part 2 would actually be me showing you how to formulate this edge gel and making it meet our requirements. So make sure you come back, make sure you have your notification bells on, so when you know when I post this video, it would also be on the community tab as well. Don't forget to follow Natural Nay and Natural Nay Formulations. And also, if you would like to book a one-on-one consultation, that will be in the links down below. If you would like to just order some hair care products, some moisturizing hair care products, I suggest you to go right to Natural Nay, formulated with plant-based ingredients. And till next time, have a nice day, everyone. Bye.